everybody. I'm Ms. Linda, and I'm the head of children's services at the Greenwood Public Library. Welcome to another fun edition of Full Steam Ahead, where we have fun projects going with science, technology, engineering, art, and math. I almost forgot how to spell it. So thank you so much for joining us. Today we are going to be doing what I call pasta sculpture. It's really freehand. You can do whatever you want with it, to be honest with you. But I want to show you a couple of different techniques that I've used. Being a children's librarian, I always have a lot of really interesting supplies around, and we always have a ton of pasta. Miss Anne, I would have thought one time was the pasta queen, but I actually have used this for a lot of different projects. So you can do so many things with it. You can obviously make jewelry out of it. Today we're actually going to do some sculpture and 3D and also on paper. And I want to show you what you can do with it because there's so many different shapes. And it's a really cheap art form because, you know, very often you can get an entire box for less than a dollar, which is great. And you can do fun things with it like color it. All right. So I will tell you, I know that there is pasta that comes, let me pull this out, tri-colored already, right? And that's just natural because they're colored like with vegetables. So spinach and tomato and all that good stuff, and they actually a little bit of flavor to them. And so you don't actually, if you're using these, you wouldn't have to go ahead and color. But, you know, for the most part, you know, our pasta looks like this. And if you want to do something kind of fun with it, like turn it into this, here's a really fun and easy way to do it. So you kind of get a twofer today. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do, I'm going to move this stuff out of the way until we need it. All right, I'm going to show you how to color pasta before we actually start working with it. So I have a tray, and I usually put, you know, several layers of paper towel down because we are going to be using some food coloring on this. I just put a Ziploc. Right, which just, I have just different pasta shapes in here. You don't have to use different ones. You can just use one. I usually put about maybe a quarter cup of alcohol. This is just plain rubbing alcohol that you have hanging around the house. Given we all have this at this point, I'm sure. Okay. And just regular food coloring. You can also use the food gel. It does come out actually a little more vibrant, but most of the time I don't have that on hand unless I'm doing something special. But I always have regular food coloring, and I generally have neon food coloring, but I used it. So today I'm going to be making green because I'm a little bit low on that color. And I'm just going to put in, depending on how dark you want it, you just put in as much as you want. I actually want this to be fairly dark, so I am going to give it 3 or 4 really good squirts. I did not count the drops, but and the nice thing about it is you can mix it up, and if it's not as dark as you want, you can go back and add more color to it. Okay, so I'm just going to close that, and then we are just going to mix it up. And you want to mix it up well. And the other thing is you can let it set. So actually, the longer you let it set, the darker it will be. You want to be sure to get it all lifted up from the bottom because that's where a lot of that alcohol and color set. And you want to be sure and get that all mixed up. Okay. So I said the longer you let it set, that little bit darker that it gets, right? So I'm going to put in just a little bit more coloring on this one because I am impatient today. And although it's already a pretty good color. So I'm going to mix it up just a little bit more. All right. And I'm going to let that set to the side just a little bit, and I'm going to show you what we're going to do with that, and then we'll go back and look at it here just shortly. So we're doing sculpture. I actually have a lot of these little foam pieces that you can get at the hardware store. I use them a lot for construction when we're doing engineering projects with our STEAM program. So I just actually cut one up. And to be honest, usually what I have to do is measure it, score it, break it off over a table. It will snap right off. If you try cutting it, like I forgot and did, you will get kind of a rough edge. It's still fine. It's just a nice base to have, rather than have to worry about, do I have a board or what's really going to be heavy enough? Because pasta can be a little bit heavy, and we're going to be using pasta and pipe cleaners because I have a lot of those on hand as well. All right. And so I'm going to show you just real quick. I did this one. I started out because I wanted to see if I could do a person. So I just put, I can do a person, but he's a little heavy, so we need some help. That's why he's got a little handrail there holding him up. But also because this tends to be very abstract art, right? So that's what we're doing. All right. So the first thing I did was I have my foam base. This one is about an inch and a half. I think you can actually get thinner foam than this, or use a foam bowl. I've actually used that, turned it upside down, and poked through the bottom of it. As long as there's a little bit of a place for your pipe cleaner to go, it will work. All right, so I'm just going to poke that in. And I'm going to put a couple of them in. And this is, like I said, it's very free form. So, you know, you can mix things up. I had some glitter pipe cleaners, and I'm going to be honest, those went in really well. I think they have a stronger, wider wire in them. All right, put another one in here. Okay, and you can thread them first if you know what you want to do. Like I started making this, my little person guy, and then I put him in, and you'll notice why I have to have a, yeah, still always green on me. I cannot do this project without wearing color, so that's why everything is covered up. All right, so the next thing you're going to do is figure out what you want to do with this. So I have all kinds of colored pasta in here. So maybe I want to put, I like rigatoni, it's one of my favorites. You know, if you have something that's like this little farfel thing and you want to, it doesn't actually have a hole in it, but you can wrap it. Okay, just wrap it around and hold it that way. All right. If you want to add some little spacers, I like these little deedolini things because they go really well. So you can just, and they're just like beads. You know, you can just do whatever you want. If there's a particular shape you want to make, or you just want to try just having fun shapes with different colors, you can do that. I'll do something straight here with this one. Okay. And now I think I'm going to push this one down. Okay. And because it's wire, you can bend it around. So I think on this one, I'm going to do some different ones. Oops. I always have these little things that come that come inside. And I do like, because we have the bigger pasta, but there's always these little things, like the little, actually don't know what that's called. Ziti. I think it's a small ziti. I should know my pasta well after this, right? You can build spacers. Here's a little wheel. I like these. And of course, a macaroni. This one's always a little bit fun because it's, you have to kind of push. It will go through. But I like it because it's a natural bend, right? And I'll do another one of these, and I thought I had a rotini in here. So a good way, because again, this little rotini does not have a hole, but it does have grooves. And if you want to do something with that, you can just put it along the groove. All right, just like that. And you can twine these together. Do whatever you want. So it's really your form, whatever you want to do. And like I said, I made a distal guide. The other thing I did too on this one, everything was on, I was able to attach just by sliding it on or winding it around. But I did put, I had a little farfel, I wanted to put a little bow on. So you can actually glue, you know, glue will hold on that, okay? And you can see on this how, again, how I wound my little rotini through. And we have this little radiator. I love those little radiator pastas too. That you do the same thing with them. They're shorter. So that's one way to make a sculpture out of just regular materials that we usually have on hand. Okay, I'll put our, these things apart, or over here. And real quick, I'm gonna give my pasta another good shake. I'm gonna lay it right out there, and yes, get more green on my hands. The other thing you can do, this on, I have a chipboard, which is just like something I got in a package. So it's just like, or a piece of cardboard, or cardstock if you'd like, is you can actually then create on paper, right? And this is simply just pasta and glue. And with this one, I thought, oh, it's about the season for a skeleton, and that's all I did. I actually cheated a little bit and started this with hot glue, but if you want something just it'll be flat. You know, the other one would be really great on this, and I did not have time to make it, is it would be a dinosaur skeleton. I think that would be great. I think you can make a lot of wonderful dinosaurs out of pasta. That will be my next thing. I just kind of ran out of time to play with it yesterday. So I'm going to put a little bit of glue here, and I'm going to put my, and you can use tacky glue or just regular glue. I'm just going to put this on. So you can just, you want to get just a general shape. I probably ought to pull my big bag of pasta out. I did not color these yet. And you can also, by the way, you don't have to use food color to do this. You could actually paint them using a tempera or an acrylic paint and a paintbrush if that's what you would like to do. Miss Ann is very fond of spray painting pasta. That's a little messier and it's a little smellier, and you really have to do that outside. But to say that I were going to make, like, see, we're going to do this skeleton. I need to put, it's got to have some hip things there. Okay. And I think I did. Did I bring my spaghetti? I hope I brought my spaghetti. I did. Because you need spaghetti whenever you need long pieces. And there's extra thick spaghetti. I did not realize that. I thought it was fettuccine, but no, it's really extra thick spaghetti. So I like it because I can trim off what I need. So I'm going to do something just real quick so you can get the idea. Okay. And maybe I want to put, we have those shoulder joints. I think I want to do a shoulder joint there. And then we need, you could really, I suppose if you did this, it would be a good way to learn the skeleton. What are our bones called? Okay. This one. And you could also, if you want, you don't have to just stick with one. You could, you can double up. Right? Because a lot of times our bones are double there. And I think I want an elbow. So I'll put an elbow in. And then another arm. And I probably ought to put, so all my dentellini ended up at the bottom of this thing. I don't know if I could find any. We'll put a head on, because we all need a head here. There we go. There's that. And I think I do one of those. And then we can just put legs on. So all right. There we go. On. And like I said, you can double up. You can paint this ahead. And then we have to figure out what do we want for feet. And I think I'm going to use this stuff because he's apparently a dancing skeleton. A one-arm dancing skeleton. I don't know what his fate was. Anyway, so just an idea. You could put, if you want ribs, which I should have done, by the way. There we go. The other good thing that this is good for, look, you can add some ribs. There we go. So all kinds of fun stuff that you can do and make different designs. And definitely, if you want to go the 3D, you can do that. Okay, so let me move this stuff out of our way. And let's take a look and see how our pasta coloring came out. Because I am wall color. Okay, move that off to the side here. All right, let's see how it worked. Okay, and you will want to let this dry. Well, that turned out really well, looks like. See, the Ziploc that did not want to open. Here we go. There we go. Oh, that's a nice green. So really, I'm going to use this and spread it out. And I will let this dry, and I'll probably let it dry the rest of the day. It is alcohol, so it will evaporate. But it also is sitting on a couple of layers of paper towel, so it'll take it a little bit longer for that to dry. Okay, so you may want to come along every half hour or so and just give it a shake. And if it looks like it sticks together, not a problem. Just run your hands through it after it's dry and it will break right up. But you can do, I haven't had trouble doing all these colors. And you can also practice your color mixing with this, because on the back of the food coloring box, there's all kinds of formulas that tell you how to get orange and purple and all those other fun colors that don't always come in a bottle. All right. So thank you so much for joining us. Please don't forget to stop by our website, www.greenwoodlibrary.us, and check out all the other fun stuff we have going on, programs, events, resources that we have to share with you. And thank you so much for joining us today.